this video, you're going to learn how to make this origami rabbit model.
Alrighty, to begin our origami rabbit model, we need to start off with a square piece of paper and then put it on the side that you don't want the outside colour to be, and then fold diagonally. Now turn over the sheet onto the coloured side and then fold vertically and horizontally. Okay, now we've got this, we're going to bisect this off and then bisect this off. Okay, now turn over and then bring the top to this center point right here. And then unfold. And turn over again on the colored side. Now we're going to take this crease and this crease and fold them both inwards, and now you'll see the top is propped up. We're just going to flatten it down by squashing it. Now we're going to bring this point right here up to the top to form a triangle. Now we're going to take one side, fold it over and match the edge with the center, and then fold it out, and then repeat with the other side, fold into the center yet again, and then fold it back to how it was. Now we're going to turn over the paper and fold this top square in half from the top down to the center, like so, and then turn the paper over again. And now what we're going to do is take one of these flaps, so we'll start with this side, open it up, and then fold across so that this crease here matches with this fold, and so the line runs from one to the other. And then take this side and fold it back down along the center crease, form a triangle going outwards. And then you're going to want to repeat the process on the other side. Like so. Now I'm going to turn over again and then create sink folds on either side. And the way that we're going to do that is, first of all, get this front flap and take it out of the way, and then match this edge here with the center. Like this. Make sure that this fold is sharp, because now what we're going to do is unfold what we've just done, open up from behind, and then push the paper inwards. It's going to look really messy at first, but we can tidy it up after we are done. So tuck everything inside. And now this is our result. I'm going to show you how that was done yet again. So first of all, this tab was facing outwards. So we took the paper, opened up, pushed it down so that now it's folding inwards, like so. And then, just like before, we're going to repeat on the other side. Okie dokie, now restoring the flap to how it was. We should have a model that looks like this so far. Now I'm going to turn the paper over, and what we're going to do is take this edge right here and fold it up to the edge on the left hand side. Like this. Now you're going to notice the paper is sticking up, so what we're going to do is continue this crease all the way up to the end of this line right here. You'll be able to see it because it's a pre-existing crease. Bring it up to the edge and then take this edge and the corner and join them up in a fold and flatten it like so. So let me show you that one more time. We had this, and now we have this. And then do the same with the other side. Okay, and now we have this. Okay, now we're gonna fold this entire thing in half. So now we're gonna take this, we'll take the model so that it's facing towards us, and then gonna bisect this triangle and this triangle right here separately. So first bisect this one, and then form a crease, and then bisect this one. And then we're gonna bring these together, and the result is gonna be that we have brought the front back over itself. And then you should end up with this. Now that was a pretty difficult move, so I'm gonna go over that again. So we started off with this right here. And then we bisected both of these triangles and then joined them up to fold backwards like this. So we had this and then we folded back like this and then collapse, which is gonna be pretty fiddly, but you'll get there eventually. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this flap right here, open it up, and then flatten this tab that's popped up by matching with this crease right here. And then you're going to take this triangle and fold it down like so. Now don't match to this corner yet, because what you're going to do is pinch like this and then roll the paper downwards so that it does match the corner. So I'll just recap what I did there. So we did have this, but I pinched, roll this way, and then this top layer automatically starts to roll down. So have a look, pay attention to the top right here. And then it matches up with the corner, like so. So this is us sorting out the front legs of our rabbit, and then you'll see here there'll also be a little pocket where we didn't match it to the corner. You can just open that up and fold inwards just a little bit for that added detail. And then we're going to go to the other side and copy everything we've just done. And now we've got this on both sides. Now to finish off the front legs, what we're gonna do is fold inwards from the front leg, and then fold outwards again. Like so. So we had this, but we've tucked in and back out. And then just take the tip here and fold back in yet again. So now you've ended up with this. And now just repeat that on the other side. Now we have this on both sides. There we go. So that is the front legs right here. And that is the front almost done. The only thing we need to do now is shape the ears, which is done by just taking one of these flaps, opening up, and folding downwards. after you fold downwards, you're going to fold this back up. But now you should see on the side here, it starts to curve inwards. And you're going to follow that curve and pronounce the curves even more to make it a lot more of an ear shape, like so. And I'm going to repeat with this side so you can see again what I've done. So open up and fold it down, fold back up. Then when you fold it back up, you're going to create curves on both sides. So then you've got ears on both sides, like so. And now you're going to take the front over here and you're going to just push inwards like we did for the front feet, but only once. I'm not going to do it twice. And now that is the front of our rabbit complete. We've got the head, we've got the ears, and we've got the front feet. Now we're going to work with the back. So first of all, we're going to fold roundabout in half. Doesn't need to be exact, there's no precise measurements at this point. And then we're gonna open it up like this. So we're gonna use that crease we've just made. In hindsight, we should have creased in both directions. And then we're gonna open up. And then go to the back and then just fold this down. And then just complete the fold by squashing inwards and make sure that everything's clean and tidy. Okay, and now you see this triangle right here, and then on the other side, this triangle right here. We're gonna take that and then fold it inwards to get rid of it. Easy as that. So on the other side, just hide this triangle here by just folding it behind. Just tuck it behind like so, so it's out of sight. And now you're gonna open it up like this and then fold a triangle above. Now you're gonna see there's nowhere for the triangle to go, so we're gonna lift up and tuck it underneath the folds that we've just made and then restore what we already had, like so. Now we're gonna form the hind legs by pinching. And then once we pinch, we're gonna fold behind and we're gonna tuck the leg underneath like this. And I'm just gonna tidy that up. But the essence of what we're doing with that is like this. So this is what I had. And all I've done is pinch it. And we're going to take the end of this pinch and just tuck it behind. And then just flatten that whole thing. And then we're just going to repeat on the other side. So then once you've got this on both sides, you're going to do the same thing that we did for the nose at the front and just do a little reverse fold to tuck behind. There we go, and then the same on the other side. And now this is what the back legs look like. Okay, and now we're gonna take this back here and then sink fold yet again along this crease here. But then we're gonna leave a little bit at the top to form the tail, like this. So now we're gonna come up from underneath and then sink fold by holding the top. like so. So we've just sink folded and left a little bit of the tip at the top, like this. And now the final step of this rabbit is just to accordion fold through a crease here, and then another crease a little bit further down along the body there. So the way we're going to do this is open up from behind and then just tuck the back underneath the front so that we're left with that. So we did have this, but we pushed the back behind the front. Now what you can do with the back is just fold a triangle in to give it a bit more of a rounded shape, which I think looks a little bit better than it was before. And now this should be your finalized model, and now you have an origami rabbit. Any problems you have, anything you want me to go over, just ask in the comments and I'll respond to every single one of them. So there you have it. Hope you enjoyed.